Alright, so medyo mahaba-haba na rin yon yung ating mga naging discussion sa lesson 8. So at this time, at this point, natutunan na natin actually no, kung paano mag-conjugate ng negative tense, present negative ng i, tsaka nakeyoshi. So this time, what if ang sentence natin is may adjective, particularly na adjective, tapos may kasunod pa siyang another noun. Meron ganun eh. Halimbawa, my teacher is a famous person. Okay, so famous person. So meron kang adjective na nagde-describe pa sa another noun. Ayun. So paano naman ang magiging construction ng sentence natin kapag ka meron ka ng noun sa unahan as your topic, tapos meron ka pang dinidescribe ng adjective mo na another noun doon sa predicate part. Okay? So mag-start tayo kay na adjective. Automatically guys, kapag ikaw ay may na, you followed it with na plus the noun. So I'm talking about the nakeyoshi ha. So it's a rule, mandatory yan. That's a cardinal rule. Okay, so halimbawa, so magbigay ako ng mga na adjectives here. Steki na supon. So steki is na adjective and supon is a noun. So automatically, ang ating particle should be na. Steki na supon, wonderful spoon. Yume na yama, famous mountain. Shinsetsu na hito, kind person. And benri na seikatsu, a convenient life. So itong apat na to, steki, yume, shinsetsu, benri are all na adjectives. That's why they followed by the na particle kasi may noun na dinidetermine or may noun na dinidescribe. Okay, so that is for an adjective. Now, this is your activity. Let's try to conjugate the following. So, ang ginamit ko dito 1 to 10 are all na adjective. Lively party. Nigiya ka na party. Beautiful car. Kirei na kuruma. Handsome person. Handsome na hito. Kind dog. Shinsetsu na inu. Easy exam, kanta na shiken. Famous mountain, yume na yama. Healthy mother, genki na okasan. Convenient phone, benri na denwa. Free time, hima na jikan. And quiet country, shizuka na kuni. So, lahat ng ginamit ko ay na adjective. So, it's imperative na to follow with the na and then the noun. Okay? Now, Raybun, ikimasyo. Gamitin na natin sa sentence yan. Mr. Tanaka is a kind teacher. Kind teacher. Tanaka-san wa, shinsetsu na sensei des. UST is a wonderful university. UST wa, steki na daigaku des. Miss Maria is a healthy person. Maria-san wa, genki na hito des. Shinsetsu, steki, genki na adjective yan. Followed by the noun they are describing. Madali, di ba? Now, Reibu no tsukurimasho. This will be your activity. These are the four nouns na I want you to make a sample sentence na lalagyan mo pa ng noun yung gagamitin mong adjective. Okay? So that will be your assignment. Now, let's go to E adjective. Paano naman kung ang E ay may dinidescribe na noun? Madali lang. Wala kang ilalagay. So namama lang, E plus noun. Okay, let's make an example. Chisai uchi, small house. Tsumetai mizu, cold water. Oishi tabemono, delicious food. Atsui kohi, hot coffee. So wala po tayong ilalagay na linking particles doon. Now, ribbon tayo. Japan is a cold country. Nihon wa samui kuni desu, diba? Wala siya in between. Sushi is a delicious food. Sushi wa oishi tabemono desu. Harry Potter is an enjoyable movie. Harry Potter wa tanoshi eika desu. So there. So and this again will be your activity. Challenge yourself. Make sample sentences using E plus noun.